By the way, stick around to the end of the video and I'm going to show you the best classical homeschooling curriculum around. Classical education is made up of the seven liberal arts, which includes the trivium and the quadrivium. Now, when you're talking about classical education in terms of homeschooling your children or at a school, you're usually just talking about the trivium, which is the first three of those seven liberal arts. And that is the grammar stage for young kids, the logic stage for middle school kids, and the rhetoric age, which is for high school age children. Guys, my toga is rapidly disintegrating, so I'm just gonna take it off. Yes, and we were talking about the trivium and the quadrivium, but we hadn't quite touched on the quadrivium that much, which is usually done in a university after you finish the first three stages, the trivium stages. So the quadrivium subjects would be the four liberal arts subjects, and these include arithmetic, geometry, astronomy, and music. And you might have theology in there too, although theology would permeate all subjects. But the idea with splitting it up into the trivium and the quadrivium is that the trivium gives you the basic knowledge you need to then study the quadrivium really well and any other subject you would choose to study thereafter. So this video on classical education will mostly be touching on the trivium. What does trivium mean? Well, trivium means three roads in Latin. Trivium. The idea with the trivium is to teach things to children in their developmental stages. That is, in the grammar stage, also called the poll parrot stage by Dorothy Sayers, who wrote the essay, The Lost Tools of Learning. I've linked it below. It's an amazing book. I really recommend you get it. She said, at a young age, children love to memorize anyway. They love to rote learn things, sing songs, and say poems. And so this is a great stage where we can really give them lots of information. And so in the grammar stage, we make children memorize things, read books, and sing lots of songs so they can understand the world more clearly. Children love plain facts at this stage, even though they may not understand all the implications of them. In the grammar stage, you're also going to want to be teaching your children Latin. This will give them a more holistic understanding of the English language. Indeed, you'll find all of the great thinkers of late, for example, C.S. Lewis and also Charles Dickens, have an incredible knowledge of Latin. You also find these are the men who have an amazing grasp of the English language. In the grammar stage, if you wanted to, you could also encourage children to learn an additional Romance language, and that is because Latin makes up an awful lot the foundational basis of those Romantic languages, like Spanish, for instance. Right, and then there is the dialectic stage. This is taught to middle school age children, and it was taught to children in the pert age. Dorothy Sayers gave this name to children in middle school. She said they were pert, and this is when we would teach them the logic stage. What does pert mean? It means high-spirited, lively, and cheerful. It can also mean impudently bold or saucy. And if you have middle-aged school children, you might say, yeah, this characterizes my children pretty well. And we love that in them. But during this age, children are getting to a point where they love to argument and question things. And so we work with that. We give them argumentative essays. We start them debating, and we start them really thinking about the facts they learn in the grammar stage. Again, we continue that study of Latin, which we started in the grammar stage. And we teach them logic. This is something that's really missing in our culture today. We teach them to define their terms when they use them. And incidentally, that's why we call it the logic stage. In this stage, we also get them to read newspaper articles and magazines and see if they can work out what's a bad argument here. And isn't this something they really need these days, hey? And the third stage is the rhetoric stage. This is for what Dorothy Sayers in her book, linked below, says is the poetic stage. That is because children want to present themselves in a winsome manner. But sometimes they don't know how to do it and it doesn't come out so well. They can be kind of awkward, right? Here we teach them to present themselves persuasively. I also think this is a reason a lot of classical schools pump out a lot of the politicians of our day, because they know how to present themselves well. But we as educators want to teach them to present themselves with wisdom and poise. Quintilian, a famous rhetorician in the Roman times, explained this stage as teaching a good man to speak well. And this is also a reason why we continue to teach them debate in this stage. And we show them how to use wisdom in their speech. We want to show them how to talk for the listener's benefit so that the listener will come out with something they can grasp from their speech. Just a moment, it's my cup of tea time. And while we're waiting, would you mind hitting that little subscribe button right there? Thanks. I got a bit cold, so hence the beanie. But the Latin thing, I mean, why the Latin thing? Latin is a dead language, dead as dead can be. It killed all the Romans and now it's killing me. Well, it may interest you to know that only a few decades ago, Latin was routinely taught in our high schools. That is, even my father-in-law and my stepfather-in-law learnt Latin as they were growing up. It was a public school subject back then, but these days it's deemed too hard. And that's such a shame because Latin makes up a massive portion of our vocabulary. Some estimate 50 to 75%. This is along with the German language. This means if you understand Latin, you're going to understand those massive long words. For example, medical terminology, which are just kind of sticking together a whole lot of Latin and Greek and perhaps German words as well. I only studied Latin for a few years growing up, but I found even this little bit of Latin really helped me when I went to medical school. I could look at these massive long words and go, well, I know that Latin word and I know that Latin word, so I'm kind of getting the idea of what this big long word is. For example, if you know the Latin word father, which is pater or patris, you know all these words. Patriarch, patriarchal, patriarchy, paternal, paternalism, paternalistic, patrimony, patriot, patriotic, patriotism, compatriot, expatriate, patronize, and patronizing. If you know the word death, mors or mortis, then you know all of these words. Mortal, immortal, mortality, immortality, immortalize, morbid, morbundity, moribund, mortuary, mortician, postmortem, rigor mortis, mortify, mortification, mortgage, a mortis, a mortarization. So Latin will help your kids hugely, especially if they're going to go to college and study either law or medicine, engineering or architecture, or a lot of those college courses that require you to have those really big Latin words. There is so much, and when you study Latin, you notice it everywhere. I've started studying Latin more recently as well because I've realized how amazing it is for my own language skills. Whew, it's getting hot in here again. By the way, if you're loving my video, you can get a whole course on how to homeschool and I've linked it below. It's called the Homeschool Parenting Program. Okay, you might be wondering about classical education curriculum programs you can get. Let's discuss that here. So one that a lot of homeschools use and even a lot of schools use is Memoria Press. These guys have been around for ages and they have an amazing Latin program. The idea with Memoria Press is that you get a box which contains all of the things you'll need for the whole year's study. So it's an available program. It's also conservative and Christian, which will tick a lot of boxes for educators and parents. But they don't just have books. You can do things like picture study and music study with them also. And their Latin program is award-winning. Did I already mention that? That's because it really is amazing. All right, and then there is Classical Conversations. So this is a program you can do in a co-op. So a lot of homeschooling families do this. In America particularly, there are massive Classical Conversations groups. And the idea is to go with your children a few times a week to these facilities, these Classical Conversations facilities, and do the program together. This is a great way for parents to socialize and for children to socialize together and do their work together. For example, if you were debating or you were doing an argumentative essay, this could be really handy. This is a really exciting program, but because it is so involved, it can get a little bit expensive. If you want something very inexpensive, check out Compass Classrooms. By the way, all the links for these programs are down below. And they are inexpensive because they're all online, so you don't get the books that you might get with a Memoria Press curriculum, for example. But it's a great way to get that classical curriculum at budget prices. And then there is Veritas Press. Veritas Press has online video lessons. Video lessons can be a little bit costly, but they're quite engaging and will be a big tick for a lot of families. There's also the Classical Academic Press. They offer Latin and Greek in their program, and they're very true to the way classical education was done a long time ago. Memoria Press also has that in common with them. Are there any free classical curriculum programs? Not really. If you look online, there is a classical curriculum reading book list, which is marketed as a curriculum, but it's not really a free curriculum. I'm a big fan of Memoria Press, and I'm going to be using it with my own children when they're a little bit older. I think you get a lot for your money, and it's not too expensive, which I love. Now, if you're thinking to yourself, you know, I love the idea of classical education, but I really should compare it with the other methods first, I'm thinking. Then you really should check out this video on the 8 homeschooling methods. And don't forget to give me a thumbs up and subscribe if you liked it.